Pogledaj Dunav dole. Evo, reka je dole. Ovo je zadnji deo grada Beograda. Ovo je vrh svega. Znači, ovo je najcrnija tačka.
Nego što nisu postali budžetu da očisti ovo, brate, vidi šta je stižu, da ne znam gde da je šalje mišu. Vidi tu dole da je ova žena sa džakom, pa iza nje vidi. Nešto nije kao pakao, ali nešto, kako da kažem, mekše, ali blaže, nešto blaže od pakao.
In 1975, the city of Belgrade designated this area as its main dump site. It worked for a while, but over 40 years later, the tons and tons of trash dumped here every day have become toxic, turning the site into an environmental emergency. Luckily, there's a plan in place to help contain this growing problem.
This here, in 42 months from now, will be a green field.
Over 1.5 million people live in and around Belgrade, Serbia's capital city. Each person generates about 1.5 kilos of garbage a day. That all adds up to over 500,000 tons of garbage a year. It's all collected by a fleet of garbage trucks, spread across Belgrade's 17 municipalities. Then, it's transported out of the city, and the vast majority of it is brought here. The Vinča dump site, one of the largest unmanaged open dump sites remaining in Europe. The entire landmass is about 130 hectares, over 180 European football fields. The site was chosen because the soil beneath it contains a lot of clay. This prevents contaminated substances from seeping into the ground. The problem is, it isn't stable. It's sliding towards the Danube, Europe's second longest river. Another problem is space. There's less than a year's worth left. Nobody feels the squeeze more than the site's traffic coordinator, Dragan Varga. He's worked here for over 20 years.
Zato dole više zemlju ne možemo da teramo, nego teramo ovdje. I ovo neće moći dugo, ova preko. Teraće do tamo do ove radionice, ne znam šta će dalje postati. Mislim, užas je.
To make room on the road for all the garbage trucks.
Vidi, uđi tu negdje.
Trash must constantly be pushed away. To the edges of the dump site, where it gets compacted. It's been going on like this for decades.
Moj pokojni otac je isto bio vozač I radio. Nikad nije bilo bolje. Uvek je bilo najgore. A mi smo uvek gurali I gurali. Ovo je gore od atomske bombe, Vinča.
The trash that comes here isn't separated or sorted beforehand. Food, furniture, construction material, paper, plastic, glass. It's all mixed together. Some of the plastic is separated by waste pickers and later sold to recycling companies. Some of the food waste is scooped up by the thousands of birds that come here for sustenance. But most of it is left to stagnate with all the other trash. When it rains, water passes through layers of decomposing trash and turns into this. It's called leachate, contaminated water containing environmentally harmful substances. Pools of it collect around the dump site, polluting the ground. A lot of it goes straight into the Danube, polluting the river. Another byproduct of decomposing waste is gas, mostly methane and carbon dioxide, both harmful to the environment. Methane is flammable and can spontaneously spark fires.
Kad nije upaljen, još kad je ono leto, a pogotovo kad se upali ovo, kad se upali džubrave, to vrate nas kako smrdi, sad čujemo Bože.
On the day we visited, tractors were still trying to put out a fire that started a few days earlier. The methane fires are hard to contain. Pouring water on them doesn't help. They start from deep below the surface, burn through the garbage, and create sinkholes, making the dump site unstable. A day after filming this scene, a section of the dump site collapsed. It dropped about 6 stories.
Večeras tu bili ovako s kamionima, ujutru otišlo sve. Znači pričamo tako i ovo.
The good news is that construction of a new landfill and a modern waste processing plant has just started. It isn't going to be just another place to dump more trash. This new project will completely change the way Belgrade's waste is managed. The old landfill will be completely shut down. The leachate water oozing out of it will be collected and treated in modern facilities using reverse osmosis. The methane escaping from it will be captured and reused as an energy source. A new landfill will be built right next to the old one, with proper lining and irrigation. Construction and demolition waste will be recycled in a separate location. All the waste that can't be recycled will be incinerated and turned into energy in a new energy from waste facility that'll adhere to European Union emission standards. The energy created from the process will be used to provide heat and electricity to Belgrade. They'll be taking this mess and turning it into something that looks more like this. Predrag Rajčević moved back to Serbia about 6 months ago. He spent most of his life working and living abroad. He's seen better examples of how other countries manage their waste.
Nema nigde, recimo, gledao sam u Švajcarskoj, oni imaju kontejner za lekove, za belo staklo, za zeleno, za novine, za sve moguće su ljudi to organizovali. Kod nas to nigde nema to ništa. Ništa, pod milim Bogom to nema. Ja koliko puta, recimo, uzeo bi bacio, tegle od stakla bi bacio u kontejner ili negde, a ovako sam prinuđen da bacam sve to što imam u jednu istu onaj kontejner.
This new project is an important step towards implementing a recycling program in Belgrade, like the one Predrag Rajčević saw in Switzerland. As an emerging country, it wasn't easy for Serbia to find the over 300 million euros needed for this project. So the city of Belgrade asked the International Finance Corporation for advice on how to attract the private sector. The city decided to implement a public-private partnership. It's when public entities and private companies work together to improve public services. The International Finance Corporation also helped the city organize a competitive tender to select the best partner for the project. The winning bidder is a group of companies that together possess outstanding global experience in waste management. The French company Suez, the Japanese company Itochu, and the European Equity Fund, Marguerite Fund 2. So now, the Serbian government has partners to manage and fund this ambitious project.
The IFC, with their consultants, with their knowledge, with their references, helped us immensely negotiating with potential bidders in terms of putting the proper financing structure together, making sure that the technical solution that we are selecting is the right one, etc. Alone, without some prior references, prior experience, we would not be able to finish it in a proper manner.
To deliver the project, the three companies, Suez, Itochu, and Marguerite Fund II, created a new Serbian company, Beočista Energija. Three managing directors were appointed to lead it.
Construction, financing, operating.
Philippe Thiel from the French company Suez.
Actually, it is the first time where we have this complexity and a different kind of treatment facility, plus the closure and the remediation of an existing dump site.
Drastic change of the waste management system.
Mitsuaki Harada of the Japanese company Itochu.
So I hope with completion of this project, citizens will see the good consequence of the drastic change of their way of, you know, thinking about the waste, recycling, everything.
This project will give a boost to the recycling activities.
And Vladimir Milovanovic from Serbia.
Once the city of Belgrade does it, as the capital of Serbia, many other cities of the Serbia will copy-paste what is done here. Those are the most important effects of this project.
Imao sam jednog profesora istorije koji mi je, to mi je ostalo celog života u pameti. Kaže, kultura jednog naroda se ogleda u tome kako se ponaša u WC-ima. I tačno tako.
Pa mora se napraviti nova lokacija da se to đubre više. Ovo kad dođe u francusko-japonska firma, oni će to... Oni već imaju tu tehnologiju, znaju šta će, kako će, kako treba to uraditi. Ali kod nas to nema iskustva nikako.
Nama je bitno da se ovo reši, ne zbog mene, nego zbog grada, zbog države, zbog ekologije. Ovo u redu da mi guramo ovo smeće i ovo smrad u reku.